If you ever found yourself disconnected to the past, even the past that you never experienced, you might as well visit here. This is the bridge between the past and the present. Selfie destination is a real term nowadays, and it's a crowded industry. To make a place filled with selfie-worthy decoration even though it's man-made, but nowhere as unique as this. You can touch and see various vintage cars, and take a photo with them here at Warung Bemo. Warung in Indonesian means a shop, a stall. A place you can buy food and snack, or just chill. And Bemo is a kind of vintage vehicle famous in the 80s to 90s, especially in Jakarta. Now, the question is, how exactly there's a bunch of vintage cars delightfully positioned here, uphill at the edge of Kabupaten Bandung from all places in Greater Bandung? Is the bengkel ngulik the answer? Kang Iwan is the owner and hobbyist of vintage cars who creates this workshop. And in the sixth time we visited the place, we were unable to meet him due to his intense schedule. In one of the six times, we actually visit the place at sunrise. The morning scenery of Bandung, along with the perfect lighting, we couldn't ask more. Right away, we took photos at some of the cars. This vintage urban east location fused with morning northern Bandung, fresh air and vibes, make it one of our favorite less known destination. We know this place from a random stroll at Google Maps. We saw how fun and crowded from the review, but it seems empty here. Even the warung didn't open. Then, we stumbled upon Kang Didi as the Pak RT here. RT or Rukun Tetangga, literally translated as Neighbor Harmony Leader, an Indonesian term for the smallest unit of society. Now he can explain.
Iya. Ya ditutup, we. Ya.
Terus kan ini mun lagi mundur dua orang yang keping bios biasa.
Upami dua orang mah teu kakejar. Lampu wae lampu teh 500 watt. 500 watt. Kalau satu malam udah berapa? Makanya kalau ada tamu misalkan cuma 3 orang atau 5 orang, tanggung kan?
Tanggung.
Mending kita ya matiin aja.
He also mentioned that one of the main features of Warung Bemo is to be a gathering or starting point for some off-road riding, cycling or hiking group to a famous nature destination called Oraitapa. It's like a world without civilization, and the only thing that speaks so loudly is nature stating their peace. It's a good getaway place to go camping and for listening. Getting back to Warung Bemo, even the actual warung is closed, we found a nearby warung that provided us with drinks and snack at an unexpectedly very affordable price.
Ruli, apa ini Ruli? Basreng?
Ini basreng.
5.000?
5.000 segini, sok bayangin itu di kota mah, nggak ada. Like nupi kabotak.
But we still remember that if there's no reservation, this place is essentially empty and closed. Yes, including the light. So we already expect there will be brewing darkness around 6 PM right after we enjoy our brief sunsets. But it turns out to be another gem. There are many scenery few places to see Bandung city life from around here, but to actually enjoy it without lights, without massive crowds, with a selfie stick or flash or TikTok sound, is another level of mesmerizing atmosphere to gaze. A Sundanese word for it is ngedaweng. It means to muse, to contemplate inside and out, reflecting on everything we did, we achieved, we made. From the early concept and researching this place, I as the director and writer determined to call this chapter the bridge between past and present. We can see the vintage cars and reconnect with the past even though we are not experiencing it firsthand. as the voyage continues, this place serves as a plethora of ways as a bridge. It's a bridge to know the past as the nature in Oraitapa, to know the past city life through Bemokars, and this brief of time that stopped to ngadawang among city lights. I think lack of light and darkness is relative. If we see it with hope, we can ignite any light anywhere and anyhow we want to be. And in this place, all feelings seem fused as one, either the presence or the past, but what retains is the light. Till we